Hey guys, how you guys doing today? I hope you're doing great. I hope your week is going awesome, or was awesome because you know it ended. And I hope you're meeting your goals and everything is just going smoothly for you. And I wish you the best in your journey and all of your journeys. So today's video is gonna be a bit different just because I didn't actually set an amount for my sinking funds because I want to do my challenge first, and then whatever's left we'll decide what goes in what category. So let me do my shout outs. So my first shout out goes to Budget with Fatima, and I'll post a screenshot. Okay, I know I love everyone's setup, and I actually do, and you'll get why when you go to her channel. Her setup is really cute, her binder, like she has everything that you might like. It's like a little bit of everything. And then my second shout out goes to Judy Speaks Dinero, and again I'll post a screenshot. So, if you like pink, I love pink. If you love pink, you'll love her channel. She has the cutest thing, you know, and pink makes it even cuter. But go check out her channel. You know, they have, you know, everyone has different, different budgets, different goals, different categories. You know, just go check them out. Show them a lot of love, and just if you didn't know, just keep in mind that when you want to subscribe to a channel, you have to watch at least 3 minutes, I believe, of their video for the subscription to count. For example, if you go to a channel and you just click subscribe without really looking at the videos, the subscription won't count towards them. I think that's how it goes. You can correct me down below, but I think I'm right. So yes, also when I'm done cash stuffing at the end, I kept thinking if I should be personal about something, maybe like a bit of story time. I don't know, I've never done this, but there's something going on new that I would like to share with you guys. And it's personal. It doesn't have anything to do with cash stuffing, so if you would like to know, just keep watching after I stuff. But if not, if you don't want to get personal, if you're just here for, you know, the cash stuffing and all of that, that's great. You can just, you know, whenever I say that I'm done, you know, you can just exit. But yeah, it's really personal, and well, you'll find out. Thank you again for watching. I love all your support, all your comments on my videos, and thank you so much. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, bank receipts. I always keep, let's see, no more money. Okay, no more money. So today we're only going to cash stuff $277. Just because I sent $400, and then they charged $10 for the fee. So he was actually paid $940 for the week. But then I don't know if you guys remember the little loan we took out. So he took $200 from the paycheck, so it was $740. But then we had to do some stuff. I had to send him money, so what's left is $277. So let me count this. So 50 100 20 40 60 70 80 90 200, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 75, 76, 77. So 277. So yeah, and well, I'll just say it at the end, because again, I don't wanna say something that, you know, you don't wanna hear, or you're not, you know, you didn't click the channel to hear. But yeah, life is life. Sometimes good, sometimes bad, but okay. Let me go back and yeah, I lost this because I took this off during the weekend when my dad was here. I took everything off and then I couldn't find it, but it's so short that it was hiding under my nightstand. Okay, so in miscellaneous we had $4 left. Also, when I like to change purses often, and when I took one of my purses to like put my current things in, I found this. It was wrapped in a Walgreens receipt, so I guess this was from last week or something, or I don't even know from when, but it's $2. Okay, so I thought I put it. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, so let's see, in groceries we're gonna do 100. We're going to do $50, 70, 80, 90, 100. I've never done small bills before, but I'm gonna need change later on, so. I mean, I'm gonna need the other 50. Ethan right now doesn't need anything. He's all set, but if, I don't know what's gonna happen at the end. Like I said, only groceries is the one that I actually like set an amount for, and one of the bills. So we're not gonna stuff bills right now just because it was a really small amount. $277, so we're not gonna do bills. Well, only one bill. We're gonna do Metro. My. So we haven't put anything in rent. Oh, okay. So, when I paid my electricity bill, $7 were left over, and I am actually supposed to put it in a month ahead, but I am going to keep it just because it was a smaller amount. So car, no way. Metro, no, I'm sorry, I'm not gonna do Metro. I'm gonna do car insurance just because it's due on the 15th and it's next Saturday, and lately he, I don't know what's going on with his boss's like checks that sometimes he pays Sunday or Monday. So just to make sure that we have the money, we're just going to put it now, even though it's due next Saturday. So 20, 40, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56. So 56. And car insurance. And, well, it's kind of complicated, but the amount that it's supposed to be is like 54, 55. So, yeah. A dollar might be left over after paying it. So that's it for bills. So next let's do this, and then again whatever's left after. So I got this from the dollars spot in like Target, and it doesn't really fit them like if I turn them, so I'm still looking for something else, but for now it will do. Okay, so random one. Okay, let me get a quarter. And it's upside down. Finally, a big number, or like one of the biggest amounts that I put in here. So 31. So let's do 20, 30, and then 1. So 20, 31. Oh my god. Guys, I'm sorry about mine. I just don't feel, you know, I don't feel extremely happy, but it's fine. So 31. Okay, and now we've done 3. And I want to do 2 each week or paycheck. That's why I didn't do bills. These are actually upside down. Like, why? Let's do this one. So this is gonna be our last one, unless it's like a really low number. What? Okay. So this is my lucky number today. Wow. So another 31. Oh my god. Okay. So I guess 3 tens and a 1. So 20, 10, 20, 31. I want to multiply my money now. Okay. And I'm just doing it like that just because, but I think I can do it in like 4s. Okay. So we had 2 31s. Wow. How about that? Okay, so in total we've done 4 out of 50. So, okay. I want to do, last time I checked, I had 37, I think, subscribers. And like I said, I'm going to do a giveaway when I reach 53. So I want to put something into Audrey's wallet. So we're going to spin. Okay, so it gives $23. Okay, so 10, 20, ooh, the other 3s are from Okay. Let's do from the leftover or rollover. So 10, 20, 21, 22, 23 into Audrey's wallet. So again, this is gonna be going to the layaway, and last week we did 5, so now we have $28 for a giveaway. And I don't know what the final amount I want it to be, because again, I've never done this before. So we have $28 into for the giveaway. Car maintenance, last time I put 20, but we bought some cleaning supplies for the car, and we went and washed it. So I think that's it for that. And then Ethan, my son, is getting 50. Okay, so last week we hit 100 for Ethan and 100 for myself. And up until now, the family binder, especially Ethan and myself, I've like the money that's going in there has been from like my money, like whatever I make, you know, babysitting, or I was translating and writing some papers. Okay, I'm back. Sorry, my son pulled me away. What was I saying? Okay, so this has been from like my little tiny mini like paycheck. But when Ismail left last week, he lost his wallet, which was behind the sofa, and inside was the card that I put money into. And if you remember from last week, it had $85 left in it, but he lost it, so I had to give it in cash. So I took, and then I had to give him something extra. He took $300 in total. So I took $50 from Ethan, and I took the whole $100 from myself. And since the paycheck was small, I couldn't like just put it back. Right away. So for Ethan, we're gonna put 50. So now he has 50, 70, 90, 105. So he has 100 now. Again, he has 100 again. I am going to get whatever's left from the rest, because I want to put, into a bit into every. Well, not anymore, I guess, because we got 231s. Okay, so let's count what we have left. So we have 10. 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35. So we have $35. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. So, and I actually use emergency too. So we're going to put $10 into groceries. Sorry, I'm all over the place now. Okay. So we're gonna put $10 into groceries. So groceries now has 70, 20, 40, 60, 70. Okay, so 70 into groceries. And we're gonna put, how much is Gas has... Gas... Let's put $5 into gas. And let's do it in five... Ones. Sorry, he pulled me away again. So that was five into gas. So now gas has 20, 40, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60. So now gas has 60. Medical isn't getting anything. Savings isn't getting anything. I added, I wanted to do household, but I wanted to keep it pink, and I only had the miscellaneous. So miscellaneous is going to be like for household or toiletries or all that. Okay. Yeah, that's it for this one. Let's go back to my family binder. I am going to get the remaining 20. I should be putting back 100 in it, but I wanted to, you know, play around with it. So I get 10, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. I'll just get it from, or, it has something to do with what I'm going to say when I'm done. And again, you don't need to stay, okay? You don't need to stay. I just wanted to, you know, for you to know for the future, because it does have something to do with some of the envelopes. So, I am done. So, it was really interesting. That we had two of the 31s. So every amount that I put has five in it. So like for the amount of 31, so there's three more. So, yeah. Okay, so we're done, you guys. Thank you so much for clicking on my video to watch. Thank you so much for all your words. I really like to hear that, you know, someone out there likes my videos. And he pulled me away again. It's like whenever he sees that I'm doing something and away from him, that's when he wants my attention and that's when he needs me. But when I'm right there beside him, he won't even turn around to look at me. So yes, thank you so much. We're done. I have a question. So I've seen you guys stuff your back to school and I'm really excited for that. My son is turns 3 next month. And I didn't know, but I thought pre-K was like around 5 or 6 years old. And that first grade was like 7. I don't know why I thought that. But no, pre-K starts at 4. So I just have one more year with him. You know, the whole day. So I wanted to ask you guys, like, how much time before... I'm sorry. How much time before do you guys start like saving up for back to school? Like, what would you recommend me? Because I want to start saving for it now, even though, you know, I have a year for that. Because that envelope just really, 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 you know, gets me excited because I want to, you know, have that envelope already. So yeah, how long before do you guys start saving for like back to school or... In his case, you know, the first time going to school. So yeah, let me know how long you guys start saving up. So now we're gonna get to what I said in the beginning, the personal thing. So if you wanna hear about it, you don't have to. Thank you for watching. But for those of you that stayed, I don't know if you, well, if you remember, these envelopes. Apestosis was his kids in Mexico. you know, all of this was for his kids in Mexico. In August, we would be 4 years together. And this was for his... So his story was that he had two... When I met him, he said he had two kids. Okay. Later on, he told me that he actually had three. Two from one person and then one from another. But that boy had a little... that boy had a sister, an older sister, that he raised as his own and helps her, even though she's not like a you know, blood related, you know, biological daughter, but he still helped the mother with her. So that was the story for 4 years. He's been sending money to two places, right? But I don't know, my woman instinct always, whenever he told me something, it always stuck in my head, like a question here or there that didn't make sense. His timing, I know that's his past, you know, when you meet someone that had a past, it doesn't concern you, you know, it shouldn't hurt you, okay? So, you know, I was like, oh, it's his past, I don't really, you know, it's not my business. But I always had little questions. You know, that his timing didn't add up. That was before me. Didn't add up. And whenever I would ask him, and I didn't, you know, pay attention. And later on, when I started doubting more, I started noticing. But at the beginning, I would ask him questions, and he would, like, evade them and, like, talk about, like, change the subject. And I didn't notice because I don't know. But I always forgot. I mean, I always remembered later on, and I would ask him and the same thing. But when I started, you know, I noticed that he didn't want to talk about that. And I was like, okay, it's his past. Okay. But, and I thank my mind so much. But turns out that he only has two kids with one woman. The other kid, I don't know who he is. I've never heard his voice. I've never heard the other girl's voice. He just tells me about them. I've seen text. Like, I have so many things that now make sense. The fact that he doesn't have three kids, blood kids. He doesn't have three biological kids. He has two kids, two biological kids. Okay? His past is his past. But he made it my present when he has lied to me for 4 years, telling me he has three kids. And he has been sending money to a woman that he has nothing to do with. Okay? He has sent money, maybe not every week, but he has sent three or four times every month money for kids that aren't his. And for a woman that he hasn't even met, according to someone. And it's so funny, but it's like that TikTok thing. Like, it's funny, but not weird. Haha. Like, funny, weird. So, I am not dealing with this anymore. Okay? This is leaving. You know, because of the lie. 4 years lying to me and taking food from my son, his biological son, to send it to someone that he doesn't even know. You know, and me being, and I don't cuss, but me being stupid enough to, like, make a binder and make these for his so-called kids. His oldest biological kid is 21 years old. So he would only need to send for his 16-year-old daughter. And that's it. And maybe help out, you know, his son, his older son, when he needs to. But, you know, his responsibility right now would only be to the 16-year-old girl. Okay? The other kids he doesn't know, I don't know. But he has lied to me for 4 years. So, that is leaving. Because it's been too much for me. It's just too much. Because I have, you know, of forgiving other things. But that is too much. When I've been knowing for maybe a month now. But I would always ask him questions after, and I would tell him, like, do you need to tell me something? You know, is there something you need to tell me? He would always say no. I gave him countless opportunities for him to tell me, and trust me, he's had 4 years to tell me, like, the truth. You know, like, I buy it, I don't know them, but I send the money. Again, money that he takes away from my son and his daughter to send to strangers. I have no evidence that those two kids exist, other than stories. And the stories that he told me that his family knows. And then I find out that no one knows. No one knows. So this this is leaving. I'm not using this anymore. And again, his little thing is leaving. So what's gonna happen is, okay, so I knew a month ago he didn't say anything. Until he told me that he needed to send, he was gonna give his son a house, which in Mexico, he needed like $5,000 US to finish and get a house ready for them in Mexico, which I was gonna save up for. I was gonna help him save up for a house for his son that doesn't exist. So 2-3 days ago, he said after rent, I'm gonna have to send $500 to start on the house. When he said that, I already knew the truth, but I said nothing, because, okay. 3 days ago, he was like, oh, I need you to overdraw the account $300. He asked it as a favor. I said, what for? He said, oh, for Mexico. Ring, ring. I said, for who in Mexico? He said, for my son. He's sick. I said, no. But he didn't know it that I knew. So I said, you know what? I know everything. Everything. He said, what are you talking about? I said, who's... And I said the name. He said, you know who he is. I said, no. Who is he? I told him again, I know everything. He didn't deny it. He didn't... You know, I had my suspicions. But only he could say yes or no, right? Not that I was going to believe that he said it was, you know, it was a lie. But his answer, instead of saying, oh, I'm sorry, I don't know what you're talking about, this or that, he just said, or asked, he asked me, who told you? That's all he said. And I said, I just know. There was a lot of things that didn't add up, and I came to the conclusion. And he technically, you know, how do you say it? He didn't deny it. So he's not here. When that happened, when I confronted him saying that I knew, he wasn't here. He's in Pennsylvania. So when he comes back, all his things are gonna be in a box. We are done. Meaning, and that means that I am going to start working again. and I already looked into a like a little school daycare thing that I did not want to do just because, you know, if you've seen horror videos, you know what I mean about like daycares. But I am going to look for a really good one and put him in that. Hopefully that like prepares him for preschool, and I'm gonna go back to work, and I'm gonna keep doing this. Okay, I'm gonna keep doing this, just, you know, not from his check anymore. And I am still gonna, you know, ask him for an amount every week or so. He pulls me away once again. So yes, I thought really hard on posting this just because of fear that his family would see it, but was that my fault? I did nothing wrong. My son did nothing wrong. I don't have an explanation as to why he decided to lie, you know? But I guess, you know, once you start a lie, you have to keep, you know, building it so that it won't fall. But at the end of everything is known. And he doesn't think he lost anything because I don't know what he thinks. All I know is this is it for me. This is it. So again, I just pulled his envelope. All his envelopes. I don't think he would do the same. I don't think he's gonna need them. I'm gonna put all his things in boxes so that when he comes, cause I'm not gonna fall in again. Like, this is too much. And I just wanted to let you guys know because, you know, I'm gonna start working, and I'm gonna take Ethan to daycare, and I'm gonna be okay. I'm gonna be okay. Sadly, you know, sometimes we get to a point where we don't cry anymore. We get strong. Yeah, you know, it doesn't hurt me anymore. I mean, I'm like, wow, why did he do that? But I don't feel, you know, sad. I don't know. Maybe I'll kick in later, but right now I feel calm, you know. I do get nervous of, you know, the future, you know, Ethan in the daycare and all of that, but like, let's say my heart is cold right now. So, but yeah, I'm still gonna be here, I'm still gonna be filming, and I have to let, you know, the mother of the little girl that I take care of, I need to let her know that I'm not gonna babysitting anymore. I probably start working next Monday. And yeah, that's all I wanted to share with you guys. I thought about it really hard, and I am letting you guys, I'm sharing this with you guys. If you stayed to listen to, you know, this, thank you so much, and let me know what you guys think. Don't be too mean, please. But yeah, let me know what you guys think, like, you know, if anyone's gone through this, like, how can I make it? How can I feel better? So yes, but I'm really excited. I'm especially excited about this. Again, 2:31. So thank you so much for watching, and have a great day. Thank you. Bye.